What's cracking with your snack and snacker stars? It is me, the BRE, the man in the backwards hat, Brandon from the SAS, the Snack Food Appreciation Society, coming at you once again for an edition of Takeout Tonight. Pizza Night will return next week, but until then, check out my review of Wendy's newest creation. You are looking live at Wendy's on the corner of Chesterfield Road and King Street in Arlington, Virginia. Yes, it's the same place I was just the other day for my review of the Double Chalupa, right next to the Taco Bell and the 7-Eleven. And you guys know that across the street is Alexandria's Summit Center, featuring pork belly, or rather pot belly, and Dunkin' Donuts and more. Today, I am back at Wendy's for takeout tonight to try something brand spanking new from them, and that is their bacon queso burger. All right, so let's go ahead and open this bad boy up, and there you go. I got the double of this bad boy. Normally comes in a single for $5.19 or $7.99 for the combo, including a fries and a medium drink. It is on a red jalapeno bun. Underneath that bun, you got a whole mess of crap. Specifically, poblano queso, as well as fire-roasted salsa, and crispy applewood bacon. You got a couple of beef patties under there to finish it off. And it is a very tasty but sloppy-looking burger. Of course, the fries and the drink come with the combo. And you know what? I paid about $10.59 for this combo, which is about $1.50 more than I would pay for it as a single. So I'll tell you a little story about that in a minute. But with that being said, I'll be right back right after this to show this to you a little bit more closely and put it in my mouth. I'll be right back. All right, gang, I am back hanging out back here in the shadows. I'm not real sure what's up with the lighting in here, but I'm here for an edition of Takeout Tonight. If you're here to see Pizza Night, be patient. It'll be back next week. But the reason I'm here at Wendy's is to try out this brand new, bacon queso burger. And it smells fantastic, I will tell you that. Now, the funny thing is, when I was ordering the burger, I says to the lady, you know, how much is the double? And she looks at the menu board, which I can read, but doesn't say anything about the double. It says combo $7.19. Okay, I said, that's how much the double is? She goes, no, the double's more. I said, yes, but I just asked how much is the double, and more is not the answer I was looking for. I already knew that part, right? It doesn't matter. All right, let me go ahead and take this bad boy out of the box, show it to you next to my noggin the way I always do, hopefully without dripping a whole bunch of this poblano queso anywhere in the car here. Show that to you right there, get you a little bit more close and show you the full scope of this bad boy. I should really only be having a single, but I decided I just had to have a double. It's also got a red onion on there, which I'm not crazy about, but I can get over it. Let me go ahead and take a bite. You know what, guys? Wendy's might have a winner here this time. That's really tasty. Of course, we already know that their beef is fresh, never frozen, so that's a good thing. And there's lots of it, about a half pound on this burger when you get the double. And lots of really tasty toppings. Let's talk about that queso, that poblano queso. Wow, can't speak today. Anyway, really, really cheesy, really, really creamy, really, really tasty with just a little bit of zing and a nice flavor of a hot pepper, poblano, I assume. I can't tell the difference in this form, but it is really good, and it tastes really good against that beef. Now, that fire-roasted salsa does not appear to be hot or anything like that. It's just regular old mild salsa, but it's pretty good too, and it adds extra lubrication to the burger without it being overly sloppy, and it gives it a good tomato-y taste because there's no tomato slices on this particular burger. The red onion I could do without. The red jalapeno bun, honestly, it's almost completely unnoticeable. Just tastes like a regular brioche style bun to me, so no biggie there. But I am digging the overall taste of this burger. A little bit expensive when you get that double, but that's just the way it is these days, especially in the DC area.
You can get this in chicken sandwich form or also in fries, bacon queso fries. Speaking of which, the bacon was relatively crispy and it added good flavor to that poblano queso. So, all that being said, putting two and two together with three and three, that's going to go ahead and give this bad boy a 7/8 of a thumbs up. I really like this thing. I think if the jalapeno bun came together a little more evidently, and also, if it were a little bit cheaper, I might give it that full 100% full thumbs up. But not going to happen today on Takeout Tonight. Thanks for watching, everybody. Pizza Night will be back next week. I had too much pizza this week, so I'm not eating another pizza today. And also, Wendy's came out with something for me to try that I wanted to try very quickly. So I did, and I hope you enjoyed it. Make sure you check out the SAS group on Facebook by clicking on the link in the description down below. Also, follow me on Twitter and Instagram at Brandon Reich SAS. When you do that, make sure you use the hashtag Snack Society all day, every day. That way you know what we're eating and we know what you're eating too. So, like, comment, share, subscribe. In the meantime, in between time, I'll see you next time on Pizza Night. Bye-bye. All right, ladies and gentlemen, thanks for watching that edition of Takeout Tonight. I got a real quick Nova Pro American Slang Update Center for you here. American Slang 17 coming to you next week, next Friday, in fact, July 14th, from the Northern Virginia Jewish Community Center on Little River Turnpike in Fairfax, 7:30 doors, 8 o'clock bell time, main event, Pro Wrestling International Ultra J Championship. Champion Chet Sterling puts the championship way up in the air, ladies and gentlemen. You must get a ladder to retrieve the title. He will defend that title against Logan Easton LaRoe, who pulled the wool over everyone's eyes last month at High Fidelity with that mime act. Holy crap, who saw that coming? So, big ladder match next week. Chet Sterling, Logan Easton LaRoe for the Ultra J Championship. That should be a barn burner. Also, a big grudge match. The former Cutie and the Beast continue to explode as Innocent Isaiah takes on his rival, Bo Crockett of the Carnies. Also, ladies and gentlemen, you will see some exciting debuts. Matt Cross, you may know him from Lucha Underground as Son of Havoc. He's taken on the GFW X Division champion Sanjay Dutt in a big match. Also, Rory Gulak making his debut. He will take on John Kerman. One more big debut, Taylor Hendricks, and she is on fire, taking on Angelus Lane, who has been tearing up a path to success in Nova Pro Wrestling, and she has a goal of putting Nova Pro out of business. I'm not so sure what that's about, but we'll see what happens next week. Also, ladies and gentlemen, on the card, Eric Royal, the Sandwich Squad, Faye Jackson, Tim Donst, David Starr, Bobby Shields, the Ugly Ducklings, the Gymnasty Brothers, and more. And ladies and gentlemen, you can get your tickets right away. Make sure you do that and be at the JCC next week for Nova Pro Wrestling American Slang 17.